Hey everyone, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to breathe new life into your old black and white photos. Hey everyone, so in this video, we're going to be taking a look at how to colorize black and white photos in Zonar Photo Studio X. Let's go take a look. Okay, I've already got the editor module opened with the black and white photo that we want to colorize today. Before we do any editing, let's duplicate the original layer. This serves as a backup and a comparison photo that we can always go back to during our editing in case something goes wrong. Then either go to Effects up here in the top left menu and choose Gradient Map, or we can click on Gradient Map in Adjustments, which is right above this layers list here. Now, why did I choose the Gradient Map in the first place? Well, Gradient Map allows me to colorize dark and light areas using different colors. And I can use different colors for the highlights and as well for the shadows. This is where you choose your colors. And it's a good idea to sample colors from other color photos. Just make sure the colors are unedited and as natural as possible, because this will make the colors you choose a lot more realistic. You can do this by using the eyedropper and paintbrush under drawing tools. Choose your color and click save color. You should choose at least three different skin tones. One from the lightest area of skin tone, one from the darkest, and one from sort of the midpoint or middle ground. Of course, if you want your photo to look even more realistic, you can choose a lot more colors. And I'm gonna use five colors for my skin tone. Then just add the colors to the gradient map. And once I have my colors in the gradient selected, I select color for my blending mode and click apply. Next, it's time to add a mask. Let's right-click the layer and select mask, and then hide all. Then using the white paintbrush, I paint only the areas with this skin tone. And if you go outside the lines, just use black instead of white to cover it all up. And for better visibility when selecting shadows, add an exposure layer. Slightly increase exposure to reveal any imperfections. All right, once you're done, you can hide the exposure layer using the eye icon, or you can remove it altogether. I lower opacity for the skin tone layer so that the color doesn't stand out as much. As you can see, the skin color doesn't look very natural yet. But don't worry, it's going to look much better after you add a lot more colors. And then if necessary, we can fine-tune the colorized photo in the final steps. Now using the same method, let's colorize the other parts of the photo. And once again, I'm going to duplicate the original black and white layer. Now I choose the gradient map once again and sample colors from another photo. This time I save three colors for the hair color. Then let's add to the gradient map just like we did before. And next, don't forget to change the blending mode to color and then click apply. Let's add a mask, select hide all, and use the white paintbrush to reveal the color of the hair. Since the hair looks too light, let's lower the layer's opacity and then add an exposure layer. Let's link the exposure layer with the hair layer and slightly lower exposure. All right, that looks much better already. Now we're gonna repeat the exact same process for the other parts of the photo, like the lips, the eyes, as well as this tank top. And here you can see what a colorized photo can look like when it's all finished. And now finally, let's make some global exposure adjustments. All right, now let's take a look at what the photo looked like before and then after our editing. And I'm quite happy with how it turned out. And that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. Give us a thumbs up. Let us know what you think below. If you have any other ideas of what you've done when you're colorizing photos, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Take care.